described and captioned media program in the classroom and online. DCMP.org.
Visual Learning Company presents Investigating the Immune System.
At some point in your life, you've probably had a cold, suffered a scrape or a cut, or had a vaccination. All of these things trigger immune responses in the body. What exactly are immune responses? What parts of the body initiate and regulate immune responses? What's the immune system? And what are some of the immune system problems? During the next few minutes, we're going to explore these questions and others as we investigate the fascinating characteristics of the immune system.
At a football game, a running back weaves through defenders. On a gold background, pathogens and disease transmission. A school bus's doors open.
As you go through your day, you're continually exposed to harmful organisms and substances, even though you don't realize it. This doorknob, and this computer keyboard, for example, may harbor harmful bacteria or viruses that, if allowed to enter your body, could make you sick. But fortunately, the body's defense mechanisms, our immune system, can fight off most attacks. One of the main jobs of the immune system is to fight infectious diseases. An infectious disease is an illness caused by organisms or viruses that enter and reproduce inside the body. Pneumonia, influenza, and the common cold are examples of infectious diseases. Viruses, bacteria, and other organisms that cause infectious diseases are called pathogens. There are thousands of different pathogens responsible for causing a wide range of illnesses. Bacteria, protists, viruses, fungi, and even certain types of worms can be pathogens. The way you catch a disease, or the way it spreads, is called transmission. There are several ways pathogens can be transmitted. You observe. How is the cold pathogen from this person being transmitted to the other person?
A girl coughs into her hand, then shakes another girl's hand.
As you can see, it's most likely transmitted by direct contact from the infected person's hand. Direct contact is a common way that infectious diseases are transmitted. Many contagious diseases that spread from one person to another can also be spread by indirect contact. Rhinoviruses that cause dozens of different kinds of colds can be indirectly transmitted through the air or by objects that have been touched by an infected person. Other diseases can be transmitted by contaminated water or food.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved list of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.